So, at the top left here is a program called Unity. Unity holds the Space Invaders game, in which we had to build an audio engine for in our game audio class using Max MSP. And you'll see it looks the same. And down at the bottom is the Unity Max patch, which allows Max MSP to communicate with Unity. And Unity is sending out all the different parameters, like the invader steps, the invader X and Y axis. And you'll see when I move right and left and fire, all the information is being sent in to this patch. So we had to use this patch and all the parameters in it to build our own audio engine for Space Invaders. And this is the top level of my patch. You'll see it has a master power switch here on the left and an audio quality switch. 2010 being better quality and 1978 when it first came out. So that's my representation of what it sounds like. A little bit less quality than now. So let's turn it on. And I chose Invaders Must Die by Prodigy. It seemed fitting. So inside is a fully usable mixer. Gain sliders. And you can see it's a little bit difficult to use the gain slider, so I put in a number of boxes for accuracy. It's a lot easier for users to use in the boxes. So let's take a look inside. These are all the connections between my gain sliders and my sub patches going out to the top level of my patch. You'll see a lot's going on in this sub patch here that I made called Music. We have four buffers at the top of there. A buffer object is something that holds audio information inside Max MSP. You'll see if I double click on this guy here, the waveform window pops up, and that's what's being held in it. And that's the song being played now. This is when the UFO gets hit, and this is when the UFO goes across the top of the screen. So these are all buffer objects, and you have to give it a name, which I've named it Red here, and you have to also give it the actual file name there. So pulsing.aif is the name of the file, and the buffer object works in conjunction with the groove tilde object down here, you'll see. And you have to give it the same name that you want it to see. So the buffer has that waveform, and the groove red also has that same waveform because it has the name red attached to it. And the groove object is controlled by a couple different parameters. Like here I have it set to loop, a sig parameter, actually a sig object, which controls tempo, or pitch, or speed, however you like to look at it. And it's also being controlled by a metro object, which is pretty much a metronome. Turn it on. You can see that it's sending out a signal every 1,000 milliseconds, because that's what I have it set to. And that's all going into the left inlet of the groove object. Down on the left here, we'll see the song that's playing now is being controlled by the music buff. I could stop it if I'd like to, or start it with the zero message. And let's hear the other song. A remix of Invaders Must Die. So it's being controlled randomly when you skip to a new level. It'll choose either or of those songs. It's play this for now, and we'll see that there's also a SIG object here, which is being controlled by a couple different numbers and message boxes here. So at the top, we have the hit tally object. Let's look inside. So it's just tallying up the different colors that are being hit, the different color invaders, that is. And it's sending out numbers here. And I've stringed them up so that they sum into different number boxes here. The first two get some there, and the third one gets some down here to this number box. And when the game, when you reach a new level, it gets reset by the game on time. And those numbers go into the select object, which send out messages when a certain number is reached. Like so. So it keeps getting faster as you hit more invaders. And when you hit the last one, it'll play backwards. Or when you die, it'll play backwards at normal speed. And when you die completely, it'll play even slower, reverse. So those are the major points inside that object, that subpatch, I'm sorry. Yeah, let's see. Let's have it play at normal speed. Let's turn it up a little bit so you can hear my audio quality slider at work. So down at the right here, we have a couple of degrade objects set up. Stereo, we have the left and right. And then for the mono sliders, we have one. So degrade is pretty much a bit crusher and sample rate degrader. Degrade. So those are all being controlled by these guys here, messages that I've set up. You'll see the receive objects there. R for short. Old and new, so old being the less quality 1978 version, and new being the 2010 version, my version, I guess. And those are all controlling the degrade object. So 24 bits there. And let's take a look at the slider that I have going on the top level. So if you drop it down, you see that the numbers have been changed to the old 1978 version. If we bring it back up, you see that they're back to full quality. I thought it'd be pretty cool just to do that. So, threw that in there. And that's pretty much the big points of my project here. So, I guess there's nothing left to do but play the damn game. Let's check it out. Invaders must die.